been a fall tradition now for the past 30 years in the Piedmont, the Carolina Cup bicycle race at Country Park in Greensboro, a day of racing for all levels of competition. And Jim McSorley was on the course today. Jimmy, a beautiful day for racing. I know you love the two-wheel kind of racing.
That's right, and I like riding around Country Park in Greensboro and Battleground Park. We got a lot of great tracks here. And it's really a sport where you can take family and friends out, no matter what your age. And that's one of the unique aspects of cycling, is that no matter what age, families and friends can go together and participate in cycling. So forgive me if I sound like the ringmaster at a circus. Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, here's a great show in Greensboro today. 14 races make up the Carolina Cup, $8,000 up for grabs, along with other prizes like weekend getaways. From those under 45 inches to folks over 45 years young, people from all over the Southeast come to town to compete or just take a walk in the park watching the races. In the first women's race of the day, Winston-Salem's Beverly Robinson won enough money to, well, maybe buy a new helmet. But cycling's a sport where winning truly isn't everything.
Anytime you get in competition, especially if you do well, it's very much of an adrenaline rush, and it sort of feeds the animal, you know, the competitive beast. When you start getting more physically fit and riding better, that gets to be very satisfying. Also, the races give you goals for your fitness.
The main event, the Carolina Cup, featured pro class riders in a 40-lap, 64-mile race. Now these guys are serious cyclers, making the sport a science lesson in biology, physics, and anatomy.
I really concentrate on my breathing to get all the oxygen to my muscles as possible, so when I go for that final sprint, I'll have as much oxygen available to my muscles to have a really fast burst to the finish line. As an endurance athlete, you kind of thrive on a little bit of pain, like the lactic acid threshold. And, you know, for me, it's all about the tactics and the thought process.
Greensboro's Andrew Crater, the hometown favorite, was dueling for the lead with Australian Jeff Hopkins as they rounded Turtle Turn on the last lap. Down the stretch they came. On the sprint to the finish line, Hopkins beat Crater by a nose to win top prize, $850.
It was kind of cat and mouse out of the last turn, but forcing me to come into the win, which, you know, just I didn't have quite enough, maybe because I came through out of the draft instead of in the draft, that's why he beat me by less than an inch.
The pros may have been the main event, but the peewees were the stars of the show. Training wheels and tricycles optional. Even big wheels keep on turning. Special Olympians from High Point stole the show and the hearts of those watching.
Most of us has been together since about 12 years, yeah. Some of it, we get new people that comes in, and so the new people we try to bring in and teach them different techniques, and we get pretty close, and we always love for new people to join us and to see what we can do.
And Billy Quick has won nearly 100 Special Olympic medals, from cycling and marathons to ice skating and bowling. He's going to ride in the Faces of America race. It's going to go from New York to Washington, benefiting September 11th charities.
That's a good fellow right there, and we see him a lot. Thank you very much, Jimmy.